Okay, let's start with the preparing the electrodes. Please face the camera. Okay, so. We'll place these reference electrode behind the ear, the ground electrode on the shoulder, and let me also prepare here for the central electrodes and the occipital electrodes. Okay. These will record your eye movements. The lens of the eye cornea has a bit of a negative charge compared to the back of the eye, so that when you move your eyes, it creates an electrical field that we can pick up. I'll place this one as a ground electrode, and then what remains are the EEG. Using 1020 paste. That nicely connects with the scalp. There we go. Try not to move too much at this point while the paste dries. Have a central derivation and an occipital posterior derivation, so that we'll be able to measure both visual and auditory evoked potentials and oscillations of the brain to see a response to our stimuli. There you go. So while those dry, we will attach the leads here. Sorry, this will clack. There we go. And the ground lead. Sorry. Use some tape to get all the wires attached to your body and out of your movement and vision. We now can plug it into our portable EEG device. Oh, I forgot still to do the reference electrodes. It's very important. All electrographicity is the potential difference between the reference and the active electrodes.
This one?
Yeah. I place it on the bone behind the ear because that's where we don't have much muscle activity, which is one of the major sources of noise in EEG. Less so in other measures of electrical activity of the brain, but EEG is very susceptible because the muscles are right underneath the skin and create strong electrical fields when they contract. Okay, that's perfect. We have our reference electrodes. The two occipital ones. Can you hold this, please?
Yes.
And I will use some extra tape for this electrode to make sure it doesn't move. Okay, so here we have the central electrodes, 1 and 2, and then the electrooculogram. Okay, let me try to establish connection, and yes, I'll attach it here to your belt. Now please sit up straight and look straight into the camera. Okay, please keep looking at the screen and I'll start recording your activity. Okay. Just as a test, could you please chew a little bit? Very good. Blink your eyes. Very good. Now, let's relax. Close your eyes, and if you can imagine going through a long dark tunnel. I will now ask you to do some exercises. I will place a table in front of you.
Now, I will ask you to manipulate and assemble the elements in front of you and get familiar with them. I would like you to ask yourself the following questions. How much space do you need? Where do you want to sleep? Shall I wait for you? Do you want to feel? Do I need to proceed slower? How do you feel now? Please think that again. What kind of environment would you like to have around your house? Imagine green, please. Slower, please. Yes. For you, is there an ideal living space? I'm sorry. Please try again. I'm sorry. Please try again. Very good. Are you distracted? Very, very good. What do I mean to you? Think about the difference between a positive space and a negative space. Are you defining the space, or is the space defining you? your desire ruled by limitations? When you leave, what part of you do you leave behind?